issue that is taking place right now as we speak in Princeton. I'll give you a quick background before I introduce my guest. I served on the board, the Princeton Battlefield Society trustee board, for about 10 years. And it was a fight. And it was a fight to preserve a piece of American history that is right in the middle of New Jersey in Princeton. There is, if you haven't been to it, there out on Mercer Road in Princeton, there is a great battlefield site that is very well preserved. You know, they cut the lawn, you can tour, there's a Clark House, there's a monument that was erected to honor the fallen British and American soldiers. So it's a part of our history that many say, historians will tell you, it was the turning point in the war for our independence. And the Institute for Advanced Study, which is adjacent to the site, has had a proposal in the works for more than a decade to build faculty housing. Now, why they need to do this on parts of the battlefield that literally beyond any doubt, at least in my mind, from all the studies we've done, men died on that very spot. I mean, you know, other than the low-hanging fruit here to say, haven't they seen Poltergeist? This is just, it's a desecration of something that should be looked at as hallowed ground. We already have enough problems in this country of forgetting our history. And the idea that, you know, with a vibrant housing market in Princeton, that the university or the Institute for Advanced Studies needs this particular spot, I think is reprehensible. But, you know, again, that's my thought. Judge Mary Jacobson weighed in and in the negative, and she's in the news a lot, Mercer County Superior Court judge. But I'm joined by Bruce Afrin. Now, Bruce is an attorney, and he has taken up many causes like this one. But this one, I think, in particular, has got him going where he is trying to push this legal fight forward to stop the desecration of this hallowed ground. Bruce Afrin, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning, Bill. Glad to be here.
All right. So, Bruce, have I captured the essence of what's happening? And can you give us the update and maybe correct anything that I got wrong? Or just tell us, where are we in this battle?
Well, we are just where you said, Bill. The Institute for Advanced Study this morning and yesterday is excavating trenches on the site, this place where men fought and died in the Revolution. It turned the Revolution. As Jerry Hurwitz, our president, said, my client's president said, this is hallowed ground, just as you said, Bill. It made the difference in the American Revolution. It gained control of New Jersey for the Americans. They never lost it, and that led to the final victory at Yorktown, because Washington could supply his troops right through the center of the country. The Institute right now is trying to build 15 houses on this site. They don't need these houses. They've lived for 84 years without them. They're the most renowned academic organization in the world. Professors kill to get those jobs, where they can sit and think and research and never teach and never write a single word and still get their salary. It is the most coveted job in the world, and people will come there whether they have these extra houses or not. But what's being lost is this intact battlefield that is exactly as it was in 1777. It's literally a miraculous survivor of that time.
Now, let me ask you, tell me about the legal fight. I agree with you. If you've not been to the Princeton battlefield site, it's right off of Mercer Road. You can get to it from Route 1. You can get to it from Nassau Street, Route 27. It's very easy to get to. And it is there are reenactments that go on. There's the Clark House, again, well preserved. This is a place where our wounded were treated during and after the battle. So there's so much history there. But Bruce, Mary Jacobson rejected your appeal. Is that right?
She did reject our appeal. She was the first judge to hear it. It still hasn't gone to the appellate court, and they have exactly the same authority. So it's not even been heard by them yet.
So why is there not a stay on the construction? How are they digging ditches where they are likely to uncover? I mean, who knows what those bulldozers are going to pull up? I know when we did a study when I was on the board years ago, there were buttons and brass buckles and shot from muskets.
Oh, there's no question about it. We have the exact lines where the British and the Americans stood and fought and then retreated from. Looking at the surveys, it's like seeing a moving picture of the battle. We know exactly what happened, literally where they want to build houses. Now, to Judge Jacobson's credit, though I don't agree with her decision, she did issue a stay. And that stay was not continued by the appellate division. What One of the judges said, actually Judge Guadagno, said that, oh, it's all right because after the field is plowed over, the Institute can restore it to its original contour lines. Well, that's sort of like creating a fake Amazon River in Disneyland. We have the literal land where these men fought and died. It's preserved right now.
Yeah.
And yes, you can actually restore it technically to the contour lines, but you've destroyed the very place where these men fought and died.
And I think that's the important context, that this is not about having a park where kids can go fly a kite and walk through and sunbathe. This is actually about recognizing a spot where men lost their lives fighting for our independence. And what's interesting about Princeton Battlefield 2 is there is also equal recognition for the Hessians and the British soldiers that lost their lives. So there's a recognition of the rich history. And I think back, it would be like doing an underwater Disney tour at the Arizona in Pearl Harbor. You know,
yeah, I think you're right. I think that's what it would be like doing. And we're talking about really a sacred place for many people, British, Americans, Germans. And it survived somehow, this piece of land from development.
So what's next for you? And how can our listeners help if they're interested? I mean, I want to hear from you, 1-800-283-101.5, about this, because I think this is a crisis across the country that we forget our history. What can our listeners do?
Well, first of all, the Christie administration yesterday refused to step in and save the field. We went to the lieutenant governor. She was supportive. The DEP has refused to revoke wetlands permits. We've shown there are wetlands there, and that's the way you preserve a historic site. And the administration refuses to step in to protect it. So for one thing, people should be bombarding Governor Christie's office. They should be calling. They should be going down there.
And what about the DEP? What's the number that they ought to call for the DEP? I'll tweet it out as well. Bob Martin is the commissioner. And, you know, and I've known these guys, my work in politics for years. I'm very disappointed that all the bluster and all the stuff you hear about preservation, wetlands, what an opportunity to act on the rhetoric, and they won't do it.
Governor Christie would be a hero throughout the nation if DEP would issue that stay. And that's all we ask is a stay so the court can see this on the merits without it being destroyed. I don't have the number for DEP, but I can tell you.
I'll get it.
The Civil War Trust
has
a petition on change.org.
Okay.
So far, 10,000 people have signed it within about 3 days.
Are you on Twitter?
I am not on Twitter, I hate to say.
All right. Here's what I'll do. I will tweet it out. If you can send me a note, text me a note of the link for that, I will tweet that out. Because I got to jump now for traffic and weather, but I do appreciate you coming on, Bruce. And I'd like, if you can, over the next couple of days, call me and give me an update as to how this change.org petition is doing and if you've seen any traction. And I'm going to just ask folks to weigh in, and I'll get that number for the DEP for everybody. But Bruce Afrin, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.